Not really, I'm afraid. It is the grimmest possible day you could ever imagine. It is windy, cold, raining. The sky is just flat grey, so there's no chance of getting any of those nice stormy coastal landscapes. It is pretty much the worst day you could imagine for landscape photography, which is a shame because I'm in a beautiful location. I'm on the Norfolk coast at Haysborough. There's a really nice sort of sea behind me with, you know, nice beach, groins, and then just to the left of me here is this incredible lighthouse, which is one of the nicest locations on the Norfolk coast, in my opinion. On a sunny day, it looks great. Today, it looks really grim. So I've had to come up with a different plan, and that is to go home. But hang on a minute, I can't just go home. I've driven 2.5 hours to get here. And, you know, as a British landscape photographer, this is how it is, you know. You're not going to get great weather every time. In fact, more often than not, weather's going to be kind of like this, and you're going to have to deal with it. So I'm not going to go home empty-handed. I'm going to show a bit of British bulldog spirit, a bit of dogged perseverance, and I'm going to make sure I get a shot. So I'm going to head down onto the beach where the sea is really rough and there's some groins, and hopefully I'll be able to sort of craft a shot out of these difficult conditions. God, it is so bleak down here. I really drew the short straw on this one. We could be in the office now eating a pack of wheat crunches.
Well, it is unbelievably bleak down here on the beach. My face is numb, it's so cold. You would not believe it's the middle of summer right now. But I'm gonna make the best of this situation. I've got quite a lively sea going on here, lots of waves, lots of white water everywhere. So that's gonna lend itself perfectly to that big stopper shot where you slow down the exposure, a slow shutter speed. That's going to allow the waves to move during the exposure and you get that nice blurred milky look. And match that with these nice sea defences that sort of stretch out into the sea, and that could be quite a nice mono shot. So I'm going to shoot in black and white, shutter speed of about 2 seconds, and I should get that nice bit of movement with all this foam. But while I've been shooting, I just came up with this really interesting idea. Instead of just driving home and, you know, getting back as quickly as possible, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give myself a bit of a challenge, and that is to take a shot every 20 minutes. So it doesn't matter where I am, what bit of road I'm on, what the scenery is like, every 20 minutes I need to find an interesting photo and take it. And that's going to be a really good way to sort of stretch my creative legs and force me to find something, find a good image, even in a place where there might not be one or where I might not always have thought there would be one. And I think that'll be really good for my photography. So I'm going to get this shot here, get one more, and then I'm going to go back to the car and get cracking.
Okay, so I'm back at the car. I've got the map book out, and I'm just trying to find a route home that's going to give me lots of opportunity to get shots. Now, you can probably see here, I'm in Haysborough right now, so on the North Norfolk coast, and I need to get to Peterborough, so I need to sort of go via King's Lynn. But to get to King's Lynn, I can either go across country or I can go around the coast. And I think I'm going to take the coast route because there's lots of interesting places along there, and I think that will give me more opportunity to get some shots. My first stop is, well, the first big town is Cromer, so I'm going to head towards there. And I've been there before, there's a pier and it's quite a nice place. I think there'll be some shots there, but I'm not going to make that in one go. It's like half an hour from here. So I'm going to have to drive there and do a stop in between to meet my 20 minute target. So I don't know what's along here really, but I'm just going to drive and see what I find. So that's pretty much it. Clock starts, 20 minutes, first one. Let's go. Okay, well, there's our shot then. Fast shutter speed, get the spray like ice. So I'm going to try and find a couple of moments between big waves when I can run down, grab a shot, and then get back out before I get wet. Well, look at that! Oh man, it is so bleak out here. These waves are crazy. Look at the size of them, they're huge. How is this dune? Madness.
Well, I just found a nice, easy parking space. I've grabbed my camera, didn't bother with a bag and a tripod. Time's ticking. I've come down to the pier area because that's kind of where all the action is in Cromer. And I've been here before and it's a really nice shot from here, but today it looks dreadful. But that kind of works out because I'm going with my minimal theme, so I don't really need a traditional kind of landscape. But I think if I go on the pier, hopefully I'll be able to find a nice kind of simple, clean shot. Maybe set against the white sky, we'll see. But yeah, tickety-tock, let's move.
You can always find lots of colourful personalities at the seaside, so it's always worth keeping your eyes open for interesting people to get in your shots. And when the weather conditions are like this, British coastal resorts have loads of character to work with.
You wouldn't mind tucking your leg in just a little bit, would you? Just so I can get a shot of you. Thank you. Okay, so we've just stopped at Clay next to the sea, which is the next stop on from Cromer. It's about 12 miles, so I'm really running out of time. That took up most of my 20 minutes, and I've just seen this cool fruit and veg shop, and hopefully I'll be able to get a little macro-y style minimal close-up here. Let's give it a go. Got a reasonable shot of some spuds there. It's not perfect, but I reckon, you know, got to move, so that's going to have to do. That will do, that will do. Windmill, left. Even better, there's a good pulling in spot right here. Looks like it might be a private one. As long as we're on public land, we can shoot it. So keeping in with the minimal theme, I'm gonna go with, I think I'm just gonna go with like a crop in of some of the windows or maybe the sails. Not sure, probably not the whole thing though. Right, I've just got to Hunstanton and I very, very nearly didn't make it in time. I've got like 2 minutes left to get a shot and there's not a lot here on the front at the moment. Everything's kind of closed now. So I'm gonna take a self-portrait. Just against the sort of the clean sky and sea. It's going to be a really minimal self-portrait. Okay, so I'm going to shoot this at f4 just to give it slightly shallow depth of field, just to draw the viewer's attention to me a little bit. Okay. Right, here we go. So I'm going to put self-timer on. And manual focus, so it doesn't try and focus again. Right, 20 minutes is up. I've just pulled over at the side of the road and there is a bit of a forest here. So what I'm gonna do, I've just put on a wide angle lens. I'm gonna shoot at 17 mil on full frame and I'm gonna just point it upwards and just get all the trees kind of going up and hopefully they'll kind of converge and look really cool. So I need to find a good cluster of trees and I haven't got very long, so. This looks like a good one just here. It's a nice cluster. If I can get in the middle of there, that would be ideal. Yeah, that's nice.
My next stop was King's Lynn. I stumbled across a big stack of crates at the side of the road, and I was able to pull up and shoot within a few feet of the car. It felt great to be on the home straight back to Peterborough. My first stop off in the Fens was Wisbeach, where I found a row of bright blue garages.
What I might do is try a shot from the end of the garages, just looking straight down. Just a quite nice, sort of simple, minimal, kind of avant-garde kind of shot. That might work as well. Maybe that'll be a better shot for... It might fit in with the rest of the images better, so maybe about there.
By shooting them from an angle, I managed to get a nice, colourful image with plenty of converging lines. Moving on again, and I had one final stop before home. This was the hardest shot of all, as there is absolutely nothing here. The only thing that caught my eye was a ploughed field, and by cropping in tight, I managed to create a nice abstract look.
I'm back. Just about made it within 20 minutes of the previous shot, so I don't have to shoot another one. And I have to say, I'm a little bit relieved about that, because that was getting really, really challenging towards the end, especially through the Fens where, you know, there's so little there. It's just farmland, so it was really hard to find stuff to shoot. The day overall, really enjoyed it, but it was much harder than I thought it was going to be. That 20 minutes really goes quickly, you know, when you've got to stop, you know, find somewhere to park, get your camera out, find a location, shoot, get back in the car, put your camera away. It's really hard going, but a really interesting and useful exercise, I think, and one that was actually, you know, quite a creatively quite challenging, a really good creative workout kind of thing. So I think if you end up having a day over the summer where perhaps it's a bit overcast, or you've got nothing else to do, or you're not sure what to shoot, this is a really good exercise to try out, and I think it will really benefit your photography. That is about it from us, so I hope you enjoyed it, and we will see you same time, same place next month. Cheers.